vector spaces are interesting, and transformations from vector spaces to other vector spaces are even more interesting. At linear algebra, we'll restrict ourselves to linear transformations. Well, you have already seen examples from linear transformations, transformations from Rn to Rm. And this video, you'll see that linear transformations with more general vector spaces resemble their counterparts in Rn. But we will also see that there is a distinct difference. I will learn all of this in this video. So let us first look back at our linear transformations from Rn to Rm. So when did we have a linear transformation? T from Rn to Rm is linear if it satisfies two properties. T of u plus v has to be equal to u plus tv, and the t of c times u has to be equal to c times the t of u for all u and v in Rn, for all scalar c. So that was what we have learned about linear transformations from Rn to Rm, where, by the way, your domain may also be subset of Rn. That's no problem. The nice part of linear transformations from Rn to Rm is that they are given by a matrix. We know that our T of x equals matrix AT times x. So we know that this transformation is implemented by some m by n matrix. And even better, we have learned how to find this matrix. The A of T is just T of E1, T of E2, until T of En. So you just have to know what happens to the basis vectors. So that's what we have learned about linear transformations from Rn to Rm. Very nice, because they are implemented by matrix multiplication. Now we want to generalize it to linear transformations from some general vector space V to another vector space W. Well, a T from V to W is linear if, well, look at this. Well, they're, well, almost the same. That T is linear if T of u plus V equals T of u plus T of V for all u and V now in the domain, so now for all u, of v, u and V in the vector space V. And if the T of C times U equals C times the T of U, and now for all U in V, only the domain changes. So the definition of linearity is exactly the same. Yeah, but what's different? Well, if you have transformations from V to W, you are transforming, say, polynomials into each other that will never be given by some matrix, at least not directly, because you cannot compute matrix times polynomial. So that is really annoying, because here we had our nice matrix, and we will not have that anymore. Let us look at one very specific example of a very important linear transformation. That's this one. That will be our coordinate mapping. We will call it phi b. What goes in is a vector in V, some polynomial or whatever, and what comes out is some a vector in Rn. So here we'll choose W equals Rn. And we define a phi of b, phi b of u as the coordinate vector of u. Well, we know from previous examples that the phi of u plus v is the coordinate vector of u plus v equals the coordinate vector of u plus the coordinate vector of v. So this property over here is okay, and something similar holds for this property. So we see that our coordinate vector mapping is already an example of a linear transformation. I will see many more later on.